What's up, everyone? This is Josh from East West Healing. Today, I want to talk about red light therapy. This is a big one, but before we jump in, please like our video, show us a little support. Please subscribe to our channel and hit that notification button. So every Wednesday when we put out a video, every Wednesday you get notified. You don't want to miss out, right? And you're supporting us. So thank you. But let's jump in. Now, we've been in this industry 22 years, and 22 years ago, we learned about red light therapy. We went to Home Depot, we bought a $8 chicken light, we bought a red light from, you know, Amazon, and we'd, you know, hook it up to the shelves, our desk, etc., and we were using it. Now, of course, that has evolved because now people are selling red lights, you know, for $900,000+, which in my opinion is a waste of time and money because you can easily make your own for under $30 and get the same effect. But here's the problem. This is the industry and we've seen this development over 22 years. We're chasing and chasing and chasing more than ever, and it's getting worse. People are not willing to focus on how do I create health every day? How do I focus on what I need? What is working in my life and what is not working in my life, right? But people are more gravitating towards what are the supplements I can take? What are the labs that I can do? What are the modalities that I can buy and spend a lot of money on to create the illusion that I'm actually doing something for my health, that I'm trying to change my health, but in all reality, all I'm doing is chasing the effect, chasing my symptoms, and I'm not creating health. And now what happens is the journey to health becomes unhealthy. Now, I'm not saying it can't be a benefit, but the problem is, we have to do first, is we have to create a foundation. You always have to create a foundation. This is why we always say food first. And doing it in a strategic way based on our RTM method, Restoration Thyroid Nutrition, and you can learn more about that in the description. We have a free download. We do a free thyroid reset every other Friday. We'd love for you to join us. We have group coaching, one-on-one coaching, blah, blah, blah. But you have to build a base first strategically to support the system, put money in the bank, pay off your debt, to get your body to a more homeostatic state. You fill up your energy tanks and you fill up your mineral tanks. And here is why. Now, the claim to fame of red light therapy is you influence your mitochondria. I'm not talking about sunlight, I'm talking about red light. You influence your mitochondria. But here's the problem. The key word is influence, right? When you look at the mitochondria, there's a complex in there called complex 4. Complex 4 has an enzyme in it called cytochrome c-oxidase. It has two copper centers, right? It's an enzyme, so it has to be activated, right? What activates all the enzymes in our body? Minerals. Minerals are like the keys that turn on the car, right? If you don't have minerals, it's like having your most favorite car in your driveway someone gave you, but you don't have keys, right? There's a problem there. Now, what activates cytochrome c-oxidase? So we can activate oxygen, produce energy and water. Ceruloplasmin. Ceruloplasmin is bioavailable copper. And it comes in and it activates this copper-rich protein. Remember, cytochrome c-oxidase has two copper centers. So it turns it on so we can finish that last step in the electron transport chain and produce energy. Now, of course, we've talked about this many times, but really quickly, how do we get bioavailable copper? You really can't eat it, right? We have to eat foods with whole food tea because whole food tea contains an enzyme tyrosinase, which stimulates your liver to produce ceruloplasmin protein, which is where it is produced. Why? Because it's where copper is stored in your liver when you're born and through your life. Secondly, eating copper-rich foods like organ meats and shellfish and things like that. And lastly, the most important is eating retinol-rich foods, which is vitamin A, not synthetic retinol palmitate, not beta-carotene, but retinol from animal flesh, like fatty fish, herring, mackerel, salmon, sardines, organ meats, dairy, eggs, right? Because retinol, what it does is it allows copper to be loaded into these different pieces in your liver into ceruloplasmin. So essentially, I'm simplifying this. It grabs on the copper, it puts it into ceruloplasmin to kind of, so ceruloplasmin can do its job, right? So without retinol, we can't metabolize copper into ceruloplasmin. And this is where people end up saying they have a copper toxicity. They don't have a copper toxicity. They really have a copper deficiency because they're retinol deficient. Now, there's many reasons that can affect copper metabolism. and we've talked about this many times, iron supplements, D supplements, calcium supplements, synthetic A supplements, zinc supplements, chronic stress, certain medications, birth control pill, certain, you know, hormones that people are taking, glyphosate, you know, herbicides, pesticides, high fructose corn syrup, the list goes on. All of these things affect copper metabolism, and this is why we're seeing such a problem, right? So red light therapy can influence the cell if the enzyme is activated, right? So if the car is on, we can use the car. But if the car isn't on, we can't use it. The doors are locked, we can't even get in. So red light has a benefit once that foundation is there. Once ceruloplasmin is being loaded into ATP, 7A, and B in the liver, and we're activating oxygen, we're activating cytochrome c-oxidase, now red light therapy can come in and actually do its job and influence the cell. But if we're not metabolizing copper into ceruloplasmin for many, many, many reasons, so check out our other YouTubes, and we're not activating cytochrome c-oxidase enzyme, which is a copper-rich enzyme, complex 4 cannot do its job. So you're influencing a cell that's not producing energy. So you're spending all this money chasing the effect, chasing the symptoms without a foundation. And what you need to do is live in a way and eat in a way to influence your cells, influence your metabolism so they can produce energy, right? So you can pay off your debt, make a little money, save a little money, get back to homeostasis, build your resiliency, build your metabolic reserve. So then if you want to spend the money on red light, it can actually do its job. As always, thanks for tuning in. Any questions, put them in the comments. I'm out.